Former Race Relations Commissioner Meng Foon has come out swinging, accusing the government of chucking him under a bus. He resigned on Friday over two conflicts of interest relating to a housing inquiry and a rent subsidy for Labor MP Kitty Allen's office. The government made it clear if he hadn't resigned, he would almost certainly have been sacked. Meng Foon says he did disclose that he was the director of a company called either MY Gold or My Gold, they'll ask me in a moment, of gold investments back in 2019 that has provided $2 million worth of emergency housing and sent breakfast to documents last night. I have them on the desk here. He does, however, acknowledge that at a board meeting for the housing inquiry that the Human Rights Commission held in 2021, he failed to declare his interest in the meeting. This is complex and it's important. Meng Foon, morena, thank you so much for joining us. How are you, Meng?
Good, good, John. Morena, morena.
Morena.
And, awesome.
Yeah. Is it My Gold Investments or is it MY Gold Investments?
MY, representing Meng and Yang.
Thank you so much. Okay, let's go to the statement that the Human Rights Commission put out on Friday. I just want to quote them. It's difficult to contemplate a commissioner as dedicated to tangata whenua as Meng Foon. He leaves a profound legacy. Meng shone a spotlight on racism, speaking up frequently in the media for those impacted by racism. He modelled how to listen and build bridges between communities. It's a beautiful way to be described, Meng, and I just want to put on the record, what a bummer that we're losing it.
Yeah, and it is a bummer because, you know, I did declare with evidence my interests in 2019 to the Ministry of Justice and to the Human Rights Commission, even before I started my role. And that information generally is transferred over to the register. I got my register actually from the Gisborne District Council because, you know, I've been 24 years in local government and I know the sensitivities of disclosure, okay, of pecuniary interests, of bias, all that sort of stuff. I'm not an idiot and I'm very sensitive to that. And that's why I proactively declared my interests.
I have the declaration here, Meng. I think this is the one that says MSD payments to MY Gold Investments for renting cabins for emergency housing and housing supplement income. That's the declaration, isn't it?
Yes. The declaration says MY Gold MSD emergency housing. And the reason I put that there is because we did receive money from the government. And I know that any money that we receive from the government, I declare because of the sensitivities.
The problem is, boy, Meng, and this is a hard conversation for me to have with you because I admire your work as Race Relations Commissioner so much. But by God, that is a spare declaration. And it's so spare, it almost feels disingenuous, Meng. It's not enough, is it? And that was in 2019 and you didn't redeclare. And if I look at the statement that Paul Hunt put out on Friday, I note that the quantum of payments received by MY Gold from the Ministry of Social Development for provision of housing appears to have significantly increased during Commissioner Foon's tenure. You should have redeclared prior to that inquiry in 2021, shouldn't you?
Look, in all boards, in actual fact, I've never seen in any board policy, and especially the human rights one, that there is no rules or policy to actually declare financial information. There's nothing. There's no, you know, I had all my shares that I had, I did not declare the financial quantum. There's no rule. I actually volunteered it. And to volunteer that, I think I'm bloody honest. And so, you know, as soon as the chief commissioner asked, Meng, is there anything else to declare? And I said, I had in the back of my mind that I had declared emergency housing, but I didn't actually have the evidence at the time.
But here so, we have the Human Rights Commission. Sorry to interrupt, Meng, but this is the key issue here. Here we have the Human Rights Commission having a major inquiry into emergency temporary housing, right?
The right to a decent home, John.
Absolutely. And I guess the word is decent there, right? And to paraphrase what the Human Rights Commission found, some of it is indecent. Now, you've made $2 million from providing this community housing. I would have thought, Meng, that you would say to the board, I recuse myself. I'm out of here. I need you to understand that I'm in the process of making substantial sums of money. It's not simply enough to have two lines on a document 2 years earlier, Meng. You know that, surely.
No, I don't think you're right there, John. Look, firstly, I didn't make $2.3 million. We received it, right? And there's also the operating costs, but that's not the point. The point to me is that I had no pecuniary interest, no direct interest in terms of receiving any money from the HRC. I supported full-heartedly the right to a decent home and inquiry. And, you know, there's no compunction, no policy at all to declare sums of money. And I know that, yes, in the public's eye, that is a large sum of money. But however, I was honest enough to say, yeah, we have received money when asked. But hey, no
one
asked.
When was that? When was that? When were you asked? And when did you say, yeah, we have received sums of money? When was that?
Probably 2 or 3 days after the political donation issue that came out on the 21st of about April.
You see, the material time to have this conversation, and boy, I'm taking no pleasure in this, Meng, but the material time to have this conversation was when the inquiry was underway, right?
Yeah, absolutely. But, okay, look, I didn't declare at the time. I admit that. But, you know, John, if actually emergency housing was still on my register of interest, because 40% of my interest has been deleted from the beginning, from all, including the most important part in this particular instance now, is the MSD emergency housing. So if emergency housing was appeared on the thing, I would have said, oh, look, I declare my interest in emergency housing. You know, John, if I had declared my interest in emergency housing, they still wouldn't have known the quantum at the time, because there's no rules or policy to say that. And if there was, I would have declared it.
What does this mean for you now? And, you know, the Associate Minister was pretty tough on Friday. I have her statement here in which she basically said if you hadn't resigned, she would have compelled you to go. This work means an enormous amount to you, doesn't it? What does the loss of your opportunity to do this really important work in this country, and we see race, you know, becoming an election issue again, what does it mean to you losing the opportunity to be a force for good in that space?
Well, the first thing I want to say, John, look, this is a difficult situation for myself. However, I think it's very important to actually challenge and be upfront and be brave on my behalf to actually challenge the decision of the minister.
And what would you challenge about it? What would you challenge, Meng? What is the thing that most needs challenging?
Well, I think fairness, justice. And because other MPs have not declared their interests and they are still there. You know, and so why am I being put under the bus for not declaring a perceived conflict of interest? And, you know, for future people that are actually in roles as this or in other roles, I just want to make it quite clear that the perceived conflict of interest is in the minor part of the conflict of interest. In actual fact, pecuniary and bias is actually more important, is at the higher level.
I want to come in here, and this is what the Associate Minister said on Friday. And she said, had the process been completed, that is, had you not resigned, it is probable I would have determined your actions represented a serious breach of the Crown Entities Act, and I would have taken the next steps to recommend the Governor-General remove him from his office. Are you saying you were not in breach, serious breach of the Crown Entities Act?
Or everybody that hasn't declared their interest is in breach of the Crown's Entity Act. Everybody. So if they're going to chuck me under the bus, why don't they chuck everybody else? All I want is a fair deal. Is there a law for one and a law for another? And all I say, look, Give us justice, give us human rights, because this is an important issue for all New Zealanders that are actually in public roles or in private roles, but more particularly publicly, that we actually need to actually deal with the facts. And there's no compunction in the Crown Entities Act to declare financial declarations and value. It's to declare interests.
It comes back to that inquiry, doesn't it? It comes back to that inquiry into emergency temporary housing in 2021. Do you wish you had been more explicit? Do you wish you had said the words out loud to the board then, to the Human Rights Commission? Guys, I am a shareholder in this business. I am making money out of this business that we are about to have an inquiry into.
Yep, absolutely. In hindsight, I should have said, you know, it's only five words, really. I declare my conflict of interest in the housing inquiry or the right to a decent home. I mean, it's five or six words, and I failed there. I admit that at the time, right? If I have to fall on my sword, I will.
What now, Meng?
What now? Well, you know, interestingly enough, John, I haven't formally written to the minister about my resigning. Because I didn't want to surprise the Prime Minister, so I sent him a note and said, look, Associate Minister of Justice is looking at this dismissing me, or I resign. I just want to inform him of that, and I was going to do it this Sunday. And we're still in the process of resigning or not, you know. And in actual fact, now I want to receive a letter from her to give her her reasons as to why I should go. And I would like to say that, you know, given the evidence, I think she should not overreact and give me an
opportunity. For the sake of clarity here. So you haven't resigned. You are not yet tendering a resignation.
I have not formally written to the Associate Minister of Justice yet.
And you're waiting to hear from her with even greater clarity than in her statement of Friday afternoon. Waiting for her to say, Meng, here's why I think you should go.
Well, that's what the Secretary of Justice said. Andrew Cooper-White said to me, look, the minister will write to you and give you another opportunity to refute or respond to the minister's correspondence, and they've given me the opportunity to respond to the Human Rights Commission's report, and so I'm doing that. And so, you know, there is a process, but however the information leaked out of the Prime Minister's office, and hence the news headlines was the Human Rights Race Relations Commissioner has resigned. And I said, oh, well, okay, that's what you want to report. But I haven't written formally to the Associate Minister to say that I'm resigning.
Watch the space, Meng. I just want to repeat those words from Clear Charters. Whatever happens and however this plays out, Meng shone a spotlight on racism, speaking up frequently in the media for those impacted by racism. Thank you for that work, Meng, and thank you for joining us this morning. We really appreciate it.
Kia ora, John.
Kia ora.
Thank you.